Hello, my name is Anthony, and I'm currently a freshman studying computer science at Stanford. In this lesson video, I will be discussing the extracurricular activities I pursued in high school to get me into top-tier colleges like Stanford, specifically my passion for music. I hope this will help you with deciding what you want to do in high school or reassure you about what you have already accomplished. Overall, I want to convey the importance of always moving forward and making apparent progress in whatever extracurricular activity you choose to pursue, whether that be placing higher in competitions or gaining leadership positions. Do not be afraid to pursue what you truly enjoy and break the status quo. I hope to give you inspirations about what you can do with your passions in high school. Now, similar to how my common application essay is formatted, if you've seen my other video, I will tell my story chronologically, starting with how I began my musical journey from the first day of freshman year. I came into high school with no clue what I wanted to do. I lived in the Bay Area, so there is a huge stigma to do STEM competitions, such as Math Olympiad, Bio Olympiad, USA Computing Olympiad, and do research at universities, get tech internships, the list goes on. However, after dabbling with these Olympiad competitions in middle school, I knew I had no real interest in studying for these Olympiads in my own free time. The one group I was a part of, though, was the marching band and concert band. Instantly, I found a family for myself in band. I befriended upperclassmen whose high school experiences prepared me for the best and for the worst. And I found my best friends in band. I was also fortunate enough to have the best, most supportive band directors I could ask for, and a newly built music building in high school. Also in high school, the music we played was much harder, and thus inspired me to push myself to get into honor bands for more opportunities to meet people and play harder music. Thus, I unknowingly fell in love with music. The people I met, the community I was a part of, and the music I got to play. Ever since the first day of high school, I naturally began a routine. Every single school day, during break, I would run to the music building and practice in the music practice rooms while everybody else at school socialized or did their homework. That year, I made my first county honor band as the last chair, and despite my low chair, I was amazed by the talent, skill, and sophistication of every single person in the honor band, and I vowed to sit higher next year. However, marching band was indeed a huge time commitment, and my parents, being the Asian Bay Area parents they are, actually wanted me to quit band to pursue more STEM-oriented extracurriculars. But this goes back to what I said about my wonderful band directors. They actually sat my parents down in a private meeting and convinced them to let me stay. Now moving on to sophomore year. So naturally, I stayed in band and I really wanted to do more. So I applied to and became the section leader for the saxophone section in my sophomore year, and I was the only sophomore to be section leader. I began my exploration into ensembles. I started my first saxophone quartet with three upperclassmen at school, and we actually got featured and performed at both the winter and the spring concerts. I also practiced harder than ever. I didn't make it into All-State last year, and I was determined to sit higher in the County Honor Band. And my hard work paid off. I achieved first chair in County Honor Band, and I made the All-State Honor Band for the first time. Attending these two honor bands only made me more excited and more in love with music. I met and befriended people from all over the state who had the same passion for music as me, and we played really difficult music together. That year in sophomore year, I also became the first chair saxophone player in my school's top ensemble, giving me more chances to shine with more solos. My sophomore year was also the first time I competed in a concerto competition at school, and then although I didn't end up winning, it made me more determined to prepare and practice better and win the next year. So that was my sophomore year. Especially for freshman to sophomore year, I practiced a lot. I gained my first leadership position as section leader in my school's marching band. I started my first saxophone quartet that got featured and performed in our concerts. I made All-State Honor Band for the first time, and I did better in County Honor Band. And I attempted my first concerto competition. So I'm opening and preparing myself for what's to come in my junior and senior years. Moving on, in my junior year. In my junior year, I had already become known throughout the music program as one of the most prominent leaders and musicians. In marching band, I went from a section leader my sophomore year to woodwind captain, section leader, and soloist. In fact, the saxophone quartet I started my sophomore year inspired my band director to write a marching band show with us as a focus. And we were featured in the latter half of our marching band show with a one-of-a-kind jazz theme that surprised all the crowds we played for. This year was actually one of the best years our marching band ever had, as we won first place in almost all of our competitions. And with these victories came more camaraderie and love amongst the band members. Under my leadership, the saxophone section grew from a disconnected, disruptive section to one of the largest and most impactful sections in band. So actually, the saxophone section, when I came in as a freshman, they were known to be disruptive and loud and came to rehearsal late, And I set this as my goal to change the saxophone section and bring it back around to a more inspiring section. So when I became section leader my sophomore year, I started this journey to inspire the saxophone section to get back into it and be more into band. And in my junior year, I finally saw this dream come into fruition as the saxophone quartet I started led the saxes into being super into band. Outside of marching band, I excelled individually as well. I won a huge soprano saxophone solo in my county honor band, and I made the top ensemble in the state's all-state honor band, playing a soprano saxophone solo and becoming top two in California. My junior year, I also achieved my goal of winning concerto competitions. I won my school's annual concerto competition, as well as winning the first place prize in an international concerto competition, which invited me to Carnegie Hall. I also further developed my leadership and interest in chamber music by starting a county-wide saxophone quartet with three other saxophonists from three different schools. We competed and won $200 in a local chamber ensemble competition. Unfortunately, that year was also COVID-19, and the pandemic hit at the end of my junior year, so I never got to perform my concertos for the two concerto competitions that I won. However, I used the pandemic as an opportunity to reach out to professors from across the nation for lessons over the summer, and I prepared for music auditions and my art portfolio for college. So that was my junior year. And now, onto senior year. In marching band, I continued to move up the leadership ladder. This year, I was drum major, section leader, and soloist. However, due to the COVID-19 pandemic and marching band's virtual nature, we lost a lot of the camaraderie and love of a normal year, so there's not much that I could do through Zoom. Still, I led the band as a drum major and soloist to create a virtual marching band performance that we showed our community through YouTube. This year, I continued to pursue chamber ensembles and I started a new project. I decided to start a county-wide saxophone ensemble. I emailed band directors from schools all across the county and recruited saxophone players to join my ensemble. Eventually, I gathered a group of over 20 saxophone players and organized weekly rehearsals in a local public park. Due to the pandemic, we could not rehearse indoors. The saxophone ensemble easily became the most meaningful experience of my senior year. Our weekly rehearsals brought live music to the community even during the pandemic, and many community members actually went up to me and told me about how much they loved hearing us play every weekend, and this really warmed our hearts. As a final project, we even filmed a long video performance that was featured in many of our school's year-end virtual concerts. And just a quick note, although I started this saxophone ensemble after I kind of submitted and finished my college applications, I still mentioned it in my college application because it builds on how each year I'm building on what I did the last year and making it even better. So yeah, that was my senior year. I spent the majority of my time my senior year focusing on college and creating my music portfolio and music auditions for each individual school to see, but I still moved higher in marching band, becoming drum major, soloist, and section leader, and I continue to pursue my chamber ensemble passions by starting a huge saxophone ensemble that is still going on today, even after I graduated. And in honor bands, although it was virtual, I still did it. I still placed first chair in my county honor band, and I still made the all-state honor band. Although it was virtual, so it was not as meaningful of an experience. So one final note, although my main extracurricular through high school was music, as you can see, I am now a computer science major, and I actually applied for computer science to several schools, especially the UCs. And this is because I actually did a lot of CS in high school as well. For example, I self-studied AP Computer Science. I got into Stanford Pre-Collegiate Studies and I took the AI course there. And I also took data structures and algorithms at Stanford on the high school my senior year, making me a pretty strong candidate for CS as well. And there's also numerous other things that I haven't mentioned, but CS and music are kind of the main things that I did in high school that got me into these top tier colleges. And I feel like music was definitely the most important because I did stuff that nobody else does. I devoted a lot of time into music. I practiced a lot and I showed the admission officers this. I showed them my true love for music and my true passion for starting new things and bringing change to the status quo through music. And I think the admission officers really saw that and were really inspired by my essays and my extracurriculars as well. And yeah, this concludes my high school music career. I hope my story inspires you to pursue what you truly love and not what your parents want or what you think will look good for colleges. Don't settle for what you have already and always push yourself to be better. Admission officers are good at discerning whether your extracurriculars are backed by true passion, and your high school experience as a whole would really be much more meaningful if you just did what you love. Good luck, and I hope you've enjoyed this video.